One of the signature moments on a roller coaster is that slow climb up to the top, building anticipation. You hear that click, 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 your anxiety is rising, and then boom, you plunge into the layout. However, as technology has advanced, companies have come up with different ways to build that anticipation, and this often comes in the form of a launch. Here we see a typically flat section of track in which the train goes from zero or a very slow speed to now what is often your fastest moment of the ride. This is a fantastic way to start off the experience. For those scared of coasters, it gives them no time to freak out about what is about to happen, because before they know it, they're flying straight through the layout. There's lots of different types of launches out there, including flywheel, LSM, LIM, hydraulic, air compressed, and more. And what'll be doing today is taking all of that into consideration and counting down my 10 favorite launches I have ever experienced. I've had the fortunate opportunity of experiencing some phenomenal launches around the world. I unfortunately have not had the pleasure of doing the world's fastest launch coaster, Formula Rosa in Abu Dhabi, which hits 149 miles an hour. So unfortunately, that one will not be on this list. However, there's still some incredible coasters that have managed to crack this top 10, and I'm going to be discussing them in this video. So let's get down to business. Let's talk about number 10, Terran at Fantasialand. Specifically, I'm referencing the second launch here. And as with the rest of the rides, I am not talking about the layout as a whole. I'm specifically referring to the launch. Terran has two launches, and the second launch here boosts the train up from an already pretty fast speed to now 72.7 miles per hour. And talk about a crazy way to kick things into high gear. The ride was already pretty good in the first half. Once you hit that second launch and speed up, it's wild. I'm a big fan of this launch, but it's only made the number 10 spot. Moving on to number 9, Flug von Novgorod at Hansa Park is a Gerstauer Eurofighter that features one of the quickest accelerations in the world. Here, you hit 62.1 miles per hour in just 1.4 seconds. It is crazy. Now, you don't start off at exactly 0 miles per hour. You start off in a pre-show where you're watching something going on the left side, and then you go into a tiny little dip, and that's where you hit your launch. But it is incredible, not to mention the launch is completely indoors, so you don't see it coming at all. It is so sudden, so quick, and that's what I love about it. At the number 8 spot, we have our first hydraulic launch to make the list. This is Storm Runner at Hershey Park. This launch sends riders from 0 to 72 miles per hour in just 2 seconds, and I think this has a great moment of building anticipation because riders come to a stop at the base of the launch track, the train rolls back slightly, fins drop, and you hear, "Now get ready, here we go." And that's when you take off. It's pretty sick. Not to mention, it's not a super long stretch of launch track, so you build up quite a bit of speed in a short amount of time. At the number 7 spot is Red Force at Portaventura. This ride uses an LSM launch, which is interesting because it was built by the same company that made Storm Runner and many other rides that will appear later in this video. So while those use hydraulic launches, this one is LSM, which is the same kind Terran uses. And it's kind of cool because it actually makes the same sound that Terran makes during its second launch. But let me tell you, Red Force is fast. Here you hit 112 miles per hour in 5 seconds, so it is more gradual. You have a fairly long stretch of launch track here, and it felt like the rate you were accelerating at increased the further down the launch track you went, which I thought was kind of interesting. So while you could look at it as, well, as it takes a full 5 seconds to reach that speed, so it's not as intense. Yeah, that's true, but dang, this launch is still really good. 112 miles per hour is friggin' fast, guys. However, it is not my favorite launch, even at that same resort, because just one spot ahead of it is Furious Baco, also at Portaventura Resort. And I think what's great about this launch coaster is that it really sets the scene. You come to a stop at the base of the launch track and you see the show of this professor and this monkey, and then suddenly the professor's drowning in his wine. And it's really intense and dark, and I still don't entirely get what happened. But then you take off. With Furious Baco, you go 0 to 84 miles per hour in 3.5 seconds. And you're on a wing coaster, so it's a different kind of feeling than when you're just sitting on a regular 2 across. A lot of people aren't a big fan of this ride because is rough. However, the roughness doesn't really kick in until later in the layout, but even if you weren't a fan of the layout, you can't deny that this is one intense launch. It is powerful. Hydraulic launches by nature tend to be more forceful than LSM launches, and so that's why you'll notice a lot of hydraulic launches in this video. At the number 5 spot is King de Ka, the fastest coaster in America. With this launch, you go 0 to 128 miles per hour in 3.5 seconds, and there's speculation whether it actually hits that speed or not. I suspect it doesn't hit 128 each time, but nonetheless, this is still a great launch. I know a lot of people tend to crap on this ride, but if you sit in the front row, I mean, you get a very smooth experience. It is crazy how long this launch section is, so by the time you reach then and you start rising up that tower, you can barely even see because the wind is trying to close your eyes. You're going that fast. Like Red Force's launch, it felt like King Dekka's launch actually increased the rate of acceleration the further down the launch track you went. I don't know if that's actually true, but it certainly felt that way. But just a spot above it is Accelerator at Knott's Berry Farm. And I know this is a lot of people's favorite launch. One thing this one does a little bit differently than the others is this one launches straight out of the station. The ride has a general car theme, and so right before you launch, you see the stoplight change to green, and then boom, you're gone. This is a shorter section of launch track, around the same length as Stormrunner's, but this one just seems to have more power than Stormrunner's. The actual rate of acceleration is 0 to 82 in 2.3 seconds, so that's about an extra 10 miles per hour faster than Stormrunner. And unlike Stormrunner, this thing has lap bars, so you just feel totally exposed. It's a wild sensation. So now we've made it to our top three, and unfortunately, the ride I've put at the number three spot is no longer operational. I was debating whether I want to include this ride because, unfortunately, it was removed rather recently, but I made the decision to include it because this has such a unique launch. It is Volcano the Blast Coaster at King's Dominion. This is a dual launch coaster that actually used LIMs, making it the only one on this list to feature that style of launch. Specifically, the reason why it's making this list is because of the second launch, but both launches are great. For one, you're on an inverted coaster here, which is already a cool feeling, but there's a few Intamin Impulse coasters out there that do that, so it's not that unique. But with that first launch, you build up a ton of speed and you fly around this hard-banked first turn that is already so intense, and then here's the kicker. You speed up. You are currently going so fast, and you see the end of this track where you're gonna rise up out of the mountain, and you think, oh, we have enough speed to make it, but no, you don't. You need more, and so this ride boosts you enough so that you shoot out of the volcano. If that second launch didn't engage, then you'd get a rollback, which I did have the fortunate opportunity to experience twice. I'm a huge fan of these launches. Maybe it's for sentimental reasons. I got to experience this ride a lot growing up, but even up until my last rides on it, I was still blown away at how good the launches were on this coaster. But it is not better than our top two. At the number two spot, we have do-dodonpa at Fuji Q Highland. Now, I think there's going to be some people here that are surprised that I did not put this at number one. This is the world's fastest accelerating coaster. And don't get me wrong, I love this thing. This launch is making this list, one, because it is so fast, but two, because it scared the crap out of me. How fast is do-dodonpa? It hits the same speed as Red Force, except here, instead of doing it in 5 seconds, it does it in 1.6. That is ridiculous. 112 miles per hour in 1.6 seconds. Unbelievable. How does it do it? Air compression. This is an SNS thrust air coaster, the only one to make this list. It's been the world's fastest accelerating coaster ever since it opened in 2001, and it was actually sped up in 2017 so that it could clear its new loop, which is crazy to think that they made the world's fastest accelerating coaster even faster, but they did it. So what is the one coaster I put ahead of it? It is my favorite launch I've ever experienced, and that is Top Thrill Dragsters at Cedar Point. I love everything about this launch. Number one reason? I mean, obviously it's fast. 120 miles per hour. But what I really love about it is sustained. It's a long section of track, hydraulic launch, so you feel the force. And it's a quicker acceleration than King Dekka's. It hits 120 in 4 seconds. And on top of that, what is so great about this launch is it is theatrical. Keep arms down, head back, and hold on, vroom, vroom, vroom. This is what you're hearing while your heart is pounding out of control as you get ready to hit this top speed. And the best part? There's a crowd of people watching. Cedar Point built freaking bleachers for people to sit down and just watch this thing take off. You don't get that with do-dodonpa, Volcano, King Dekka. The only other coaster that does this is really Red Force. So you can sit on the sidelines and watch your friends take off. And it is crazy. A front row ride on Dragster is unbelievable. It's something everyone should get the chance to experience, which is why it is my number one launch I have ever experienced. So that's how I rank my 10 favorite launches. Unfortunately, there's only 10 spots, so I didn't get the chance to incorporate many other great launch coasters like Maverick, Max Force, Montezuma's Revenge, and so many others. It was very hard to narrow it down, but in the end, the bottom line is, when a coaster starts off with a bang, oftentimes it's the best part of the ride. It is such a fantastic way to begin begin a roller coaster. It actually makes your heart race faster than it would if you just did that normal chain lift to the top. And it still amazes me to this day that we live in a day and age where we can safely accelerate passengers to over 100 miles per hour in just a matter of seconds. That is so cool. So I want to hear from you guys. What are some of your favorite launches? Not the coaster, just the launch. Do you agree with the ones I've placed here? And while we're on the topic, let me know down below if you had the opportunity to experience Ring Racer in Germany. That ride only operated for a short time frame, but when it did, I heard it had an absolutely insane launch. So thank you guys so much for joining me, and I'll see you next time.